Hold your breath, don't look down, keep trying. Darling, it's okay to be scared,
so
it's frightening.
Today I want to talk about living in a small space with a rabbit. I have a rabbit now since September, I believe, and now it's January, the 2nd of January when I record this. And I had to make some adjustments in order to live with a house rabbit, because it's a house rabbit. The routine of having a house rabbit is different, I guess. Especially when you live in such a small space like I do. I live in a studio apartment in Amsterdam of, I believe, 21 square meters. That's why I was thinking maybe it's nice to show you what a day looks like when you have a house rabbit. So this is Felipe. Right now he's doing his business. This is a toilet. But he is housed in a puppy pen, as you can see. Or yeah, it's not really a puppy pen. It was designed for rabbits for outdoors, just to play with them so they don't escape. But I use this to reserve a part of the room for him, especially because rabbits look very nice, but they can be very devious at times, and they will bite on anything I just lay around. So I have to be careful sometimes. Usually when I have boxes or cardboard laying around, I give it to him as well. He loves it. And then this thing, I often call this thing this blanket his girlfriend, because seriously, as you can see, he loves it. And then I have two bowls for drinking and for food. As you can see, I have a bowl inside the bowl, because at the beginning he constantly pushed the bowls around. So this is my room. As you can see, it's pretty small. And that's why I need to take some measures when I leave Philippe out of the room. First of all, I want to cover this sofa, because normally he climbs on top of it. And one time he peed on the sofa, so I have to be a bit careful. And this is what it looks like with the blanket. Hi, Philippe. Another thing that I do is closing this bathroom, because he loves the bathroom, and otherwise he jumps inside and will poop everywhere. Flippy, come. Ooh. Ooh. Hey. What is that? What do you? What do you? Hello. Yeah. This is what it looks like. So it is a bit dirty, so I am going to, when it focuses, I'm going to wash it a bit. So now it looks like this. Here I put something inside against the smell of rabbit pee. And then last is hay. And it ends up looking like this. And now it's ready, and it took me, I guess, a little more because I was filming, but it takes like 5 minutes, very short. Okay, now I'm going to the supermarket. I have to buy some food for him and food for me. So I'll put him back in his cage for now in his home. Because otherwise I can't check on him when I'm not here. So yeah, I put him inside of there, and then I'm going. Okay, I'm back and I bought myself some groceries, veggies, fruits, whatever. And this is what I bought for Felipe. Because, oh, and it's so dark in here, I can't help it, but it's so dark. Take this, open it, you see there's nothing, well, there's not much left. So I will fill it up as much as possible. This is what it looks like filled up. Zit je lekker? Ga je plassen toch? Okay, I hope you can see it, but here it goes. Okay, I want to talk about cages in general for rabbits. Because the day is almost over and I will just show you afterwards what I do at nighttime and when I'm sleeping, because rabbits can make a lot of noise and they don't sleep through the night like we do. But before that I want to talk about cages, because there is a lot of controversy about the rabbit cages in general. Rabbits shouldn't be held in a cage, which I do agree, but you have to understand that if you have an indoor rabbit, it's not always possible for it to just free roam, if that makes sense. And I tried it, but then he ate part of my sofa and I was very disappointed, sad that it didn't work out. So now it's half free roaming, half in his cage, and at nighttime he's in the bathroom, because that's something I wanted to show you as well. During nighttime, I tried to have him over here just in my room, but he makes too much noise for me to be able to sleep. So I put him in the bathroom, and it sounds maybe horrible, but he actually loves it very much, because every time I even open the bathroom, he jumps in. The thing is, he can jump in the shower area and on top of the cabinets and underneath the cabinets and behind the toilet. I think he likes it a lot. So that's where I put him at nighttime. But yeah, about cages, I wanted to free roam him, but that wasn't really possible. But he's often open in the open space when I'm around. So that's basically my thoughts about that. And now I will show you what I do at nighttime before going to bed. And I'm sorry if it's too dark, but I can't seem to find a way to make it lighter. I'm sorry. But I'll show you what I do at nighttime before going to bed and before him going to bed, or putting him to bed. Basically, he doesn't go to bed, but fair enough. This is the situation over here. I put these things. Let me focus. Yes, his toilet and his football and drink over here. And then let's get him. You open the spade because it was closed. Otherwise he bites all the things that I don't want him to bite on. So come, Felipe, come. And there he goes. He loves it way more. I don't know what his thing is, but he loves jumping around. Bye, Felipe, bye. Ciao. And I close it. And then I'm going to bed. Good morning, Felipe. Hello. And that's what a day looks like. And a night. Good morning.